So the very first thing that you want to do to be able to go ahead and stream to Facebook utilizing Streamlabs is you want to come to your Facebook gaming page. If you haven't created a gaming page, I went ahead and put a link in the description that walks you through step by step on creating a gaming page, and then you can go ahead and follow along. So once you have that gaming page created, on the left hand side, you're going to come and select Creator Studio. This is going to be what we're going to utilize to get all the information that we need to be able to give that to Streamlabs so we can push our stream over to Facebook. So once you're here, you're going to see on the right hand side, it's going to say go live. So you're going to go ahead and click that, and it's going to go ahead and pop up and give you two options. It's going to ask you if you want to go ahead and utilize a live event or if you want to simply go ahead and go live. So here on the left side is what you're going to go ahead and select. Now you are able to go ahead and create a test broadcast before going live. I highly recommend that you do that to be able to make sure you test everything to make sure everything is good. And then once you know that everything is set up correctly, then you can come back and uncheck that, and then you'll be able to stream directly to the page. So I'm going to go ahead and select test. I'm going to go ahead and select. And now that's going to go ahead and bring us over here to the information that we're going to need to put inside of Streamlabs. So now it's going to ask us if we want to go ahead and use a webcam or a streaming software. So you want to go ahead and select streaming software because that's what Streamlabs is. Once you select that, you're going to see an option here that's going to say stream key, and then you're going to see advanced setting. Now, the first thing you're going to want to do is under advanced settings, you want to select persistent stream key. The reason why you want to do that is if you're going to be streaming to Facebook consistently, you're not going to have to keep changing the information inside of Streamlabs every time you go live. If you don't click that, every time you go live, you have to go ahead and update that stream key inside of Streamlabs. Now, it's super, super important that you do not share the stream key with anyone, because anyone who has access to that stream key is going to be able to stream on your behalf, on your account, and you really don't want that. So once you've gone ahead and select the persistent key, the next thing you're going to want to do here on the right hand side is that you're going to want to go ahead and create a title. This is going to be super important. You're not going to be able to go live unless you have this title created. So you can create a title that makes people want to click. This is super important. You want to have some curiosity inside that title. Then you're going to want to go ahead and input your description. This is also going to be important because it's not going to let you go live unless you have a description. Now in your description, what I like to do is to tell viewers what my stream is about. I like to place my social links and my donor links inside that description. Then here, when you scroll down to the bottom, you're going to see it says preset pin comment. This is super important that you have this. So you want to go ahead and enable this. Then you select edit. And then this is where an opportunity for you to be able to pin a comment. And what I like to do is I like to go ahead and pin my newest YouTube video. So I'll save that. It's going to say, check out my newest YouTube video. And I insert the link, and that's going to be shown there. So now that you have that set up here on Facebook, now what we want to do is we want to go ahead and grab some information and bring it into Streamlabs. So let's go ahead and open up Streamlabs. And once you have Streamlabs open, on the bottom left hand side, you're going to want to select settings. Once you do that, you're going to come to where it says stream, and you're going to come here and select custom streaming server. You're going to see it's going to ask you for a URL and a stream key. So let's go ahead and grab that now from Facebook. So we're going to open up Facebook again. Okay, you're going to see here it's going to say server URL. You're going to go ahead and hit copy. You're going to come back to Streamlabs, and you're going to go ahead and paste that into this URL tab. So you hit paste. Now we'll come back to Facebook, and now you're going to see here you're going to copy that stream key. You're going to come back to Streamlabs again, and here you're going to put in the stream key, and you're going to hit paste, and then you're going to select done. So now that we've went ahead and added Facebook to our Streamlabs, now we want to go ahead and make sure that we have the right settings so that way our stream looks good on Facebook. So now you're going to come back to settings. You're going to come to where it says output, and you're going to go ahead and follow the settings that I have set here. For output mode, you're going to select advanced. For encoder, you're going to select X264. For the CBR rate control, you're going to put in 6,000. Now, this is going to vary based on your internet speed. So this is very important that you pause the video for a moment and go to speedtest.net. I put a link in the description for that. And you're going to go ahead and test your internet speed. Now, what you want to focus on is going to be your upload speed. You want this to be at least 10 or higher to be able to get a smooth stream. If your upload is above 10, then you can go ahead and put the kind of max bit rate for Facebook, which is about 6,000. Then for the keyframe interval, you're going to put 2. For CPU usage, you're going to put very fast. And then for the profile, you're going to put high. You're going to go ahead and hit done there. And now what you want to do is you want to go ahead and select go live. It's going to say go live. And now what we want to do is you want to come back to Facebook and we're going to make sure that it's going to say connecting live video. So you want to make sure that that's there. Now you'll see here that the live video is connected. We're good to go. And what you want to do is now you want to go ahead and hit start test. Now this is very important. Even when you're not doing a test, once you press go live inside of Streamlabs, you still got to come back to your Facebook page and select the go live. This will say go live instead of saying start test. And then that's going to go ahead and push it off to your Facebook gaming page and people are going to be able to see it. Now, what I want you to do is that I want you to go in the description of this video and I want you to go ahead and download the PDF free guide that I went ahead and created, the Ultimate Streamer Checklist. This checklist is going to give you everything you need to know before you go live so that way you know how to prep, you know everything you need to do to have success when you go live. I'm going to teach you what to do during your live stream to make sure you get people to subscribe, to donate, to just be a part of your community and want to come back. And then I'm also going to show you what to do after your live stream so that way you know what you need to do to be able to grow it so that way people find you when you're offline. So go into the description of this video to be able to download that free guide. Now if you want to know how to go ahead and add overlays to your Facebook stream so that it looks professional, go ahead and check out this video right here where I even give you free overlays you can utilize inside of Streamlabs, and I even walk you step by step on setting it up. Click that video right there. I'll see you guys in the next video.